I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Professor Chitra Harshvardhan, who's been teaching the theory of translation and methodology of translation at the Jawaharlal Nehru University for almost three decades now. And I also teach simultaneous and consecutive interpretation in German studies. That's my department. And I'd like to introduce my course to you, which will be actually an introduction to the theories of translation. The title of the course is Theories of Translation and Introduction. The reason that I am actually wanting to offer this course to you is that I find translation extremely exciting. Most people, however, feel that theory is not necessary and is not really relevant in the realm of translation, and practice is all there is. Like in all other fields, translation also demands both theoretical and practical knowledge. And I do believe, and I'm actually convinced of that, that both have to nurture each other. Given that, I am offering this course also, therefore, to highlight many things which are actually commonplace about translation. And perhaps because they are commonplace, people are very often not aware of them or simply ignore them as not being important. And one of them is, of course, that translation necessarily is interdisciplinary. It is intercultural depending on the strategy you choose. It can also be transcultural, again depending on the translation strategy that is chosen. Theory, of course, is important because it also offers an insight to the entire problematic of translation. So it helps in explaining phenomena, concepts, which are intrinsic to translation studies. It also helps in predicting issues which you might encounter as practical translators. And certainly, at times, it offers solutions. In fact, more times than not, it offers very credible solutions which work very well. So my course will actually provide an insight into the various approaches, and there are several, since the mid-50s of the 20th century. They include the linguistic, the cultural, and the ideological approaches to translation. There are several theories that have also now emerged over the years. A broad distinction amongst them is made between what we call the process-oriented and what we call the product-oriented theories of translation. So under the process-oriented, basically the goal is to produce a competent, professional translation. And for that, the translation obviously is not available, but students and candidates are then sensitized in the manner in which they approach and go about engaging with the original source text to arrive at the product which will then be the target text or translation. Now, amongst these two functional theories, the ones that are the most important and talked about today are the pragmatic equivalence-oriented theories of translation and the scopus translation theory. The scopus translation theory is rooted more specifically in the communicative approach. Here we ask, why are we translating, for whom, etc. In the first case, the equivalence-oriented theory emphasizes more the text typology in translation. We also have another set of theories which actually highlight the politics of translation. These are very often known as the descriptive translation theories, and amongst them is the polysystem theory and the manipulation school of thought. Here you see very clearly the power relations that come into play and which are manifested through translation. All of this, I feel, makes translation an extremely exciting activity, and also the course itself very exciting because it's diverse. It covers many perspectives from angles that are sometimes not thought of automatically. So I do hope that this is a course that you would enjoy taking and participating in.